Now, many of you have noticed throughout these holidays that we've had to empty a lot of our pews in order to make them as successful as they've been, as powerful as they've been. And our mindset has always been that while we prepare for this season, we have to find ways to leverage this situation for the good. And so when we learned that we would have all of this open space, we decided to realize a long desire of ours, which was to engage more of our senses in worship. So we're incredibly pleased that for the beginning of this afternoon service, as we tell our Jewish story from creation to redemption, we're joined by Jonah Bokaer, world-renowned artist, dancer, and choreographer. Jonah draws from his Jewish, American, and Middle Eastern roots, authoring 64 original works all around the world. He's garnered prizes, philanthropic support, and humanitarian acknowledgement. He is an extraordinary talent, but more importantly, an extraordinary soul. And dance has been a part of our people's worship since recorded time. We're told King David danced before the ark as it was brought to the ancient Holy Temple in Jerusalem. So this afternoon, once again, music, prayer, words, dance, sacred space will not be considered separate. They will become one single offering to God. A reminder that to worship God, we must not only use our whole selves, body and soul, but also the offerings of a whole community coming together to create a devotion worthy of God's goodness, beauty, mercy, and love. So let's begin together on page 158. Read with me. Open for us the gates of legacy, O God, so that we may enter and give you thanks.
Pithu lanu share morasha nabo ba no deya pithu lanu share morasha.
God said, let there be light, and there was light.
Light to drive away the darkness and bring cosmos out of chaos. Then God blessed humankind, saying,
Pru urvu umil'u et ha'aretz. Be fruitful and multiply, inhabit the world.
And God set Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden to tend it and watch over it. You gave us powers we could not comprehend, a skillful hand, a probing mind, a loving heart, a soul aspiring to know and to fulfill its destiny.
Bereshit bara Elohim, et ha-shamayim ve-et ha-aretz. Ve'aretz hayta tohu vavohu v'choshech al p'nei tehom. Ve'ruach Elohim merachefet, merachefet, merachefet al p'nei hamayim. Vayomer Elohim,
Elohim ben haor uven hachoshev veruach Elohim merachefet 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 al pene hamayim. Vayikra Elohim Laor yom velachoshech kar halayla Vayhi erev Vayhi boker Yom echad Veruach Merachefet, merachefet al pene
hamayim. Adam and Eve were exiled from the garden when their eyes were opened and they saw their nakedness. Then Cain rose up against Abel, his brother, and he killed him. God said to Cain, "Where is your brother?" And the murderer cried out,
"Hashomer achi anochi? Am I my brother's keeper?"
Then God called to Abraham,
"Lech lecha me'artzecha umimoladetcha umibet avicha el haaretz asher arecha. Go forth from your country, from your birthplace, your father's house, to the land I will show you. I will make a great nation of you, and I will bless you and make your name great. Be therefore a blessing."
And God made a covenant with Abraham and Sarah, and God said to them, "To your descendants I shall give the promised land, in order that you may teach your children and all your household to follow. Keep the way of the Eternal by doing what is just and right.
You inspired us, a people born out of Abraham and Sarah,
to recognize the flame within and minister to it as a kingdom of priests and a holy people. This was to be the meaning and message of our existence, the calling of those who gave up home and hearth to found a people pledged to do your will."
Lechi lach to a land that I will show you. Lech lecha to a place you do not know. Lechi lach, on your journey I will bless you, and you shall be a blessing, you shall be a blessing, you shall be a blessing, lechi lach. Lesimchat chayim, lechila. You shall be a blessing. You shall be a blessing. And you shall be a blessing. Lechila.
Our ancestors then descended into Egypt, but with a strong hand and an outstretched arm, God brought us out from there. From slavery, we were raised up. At Mount Sinai, we heard the voice of God. We were prepared to keep God's covenant, the covenant promised to our ancestors, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, to Sarah, to Rebecca, to Rachel, and to Leah. From the book of the covenant, Moses read to all the people, and we responded,
Na'aseh v'nishma, all that God has spoken, we shall do and understand.
Soon enough, we turned from God's path. We made ourselves a golden calf and worshipped it. We abandoned God. And Moses threw down the tablets and shattered them. God then said to Moses, Carve a second set of tablets like the first. Opening the gates of repentance, God said, Behold, I enter into a covenant and reveal myself once more. Eternal One, a compassionate and merciful God, patience, abounding in devotion and truth, assuring steadfast love for a thousand generations, forgiving transgressions, iniquity, and sin, and granting pardon. Redeemed from slavery, we stood at Mount Sinai, where the ancient promise was confirmed. There we pledged to play a redemptive role in the world's unfolding destiny. God selected priests to preserve the holiness of Israel. Once a year, the high priest made atonement in the Holy of Holies itself to atone for all of his sins and those of his household and for those of the entire congregation of Israel. Trembling overtook the people as the high priest entered the Holy of Holies to face God alone and beg for our forgiveness. God, for all our sins, we ask forgiveness and pray that the house of Israel, purified, reconciled, and reconsecrated, may again become worthy to stand in your presence and to be the messenger of your teachings. We pray not only for ourselves, but for the Jewish people, whose destiny is our own and whose hope we share. Help us to return to you, O God. Then truly we shall return. Renew our days as in the past.
Ha-shivenu, Adonai Elecha,
of our people would not be complete, of course, without its most sorrowful chapters. We remember those souls whose light was extinguished in times of deepest darkness, but whose legacy lives on through us, the martyrs of our people. These things do I remember, and my heart is grieved, how the arrogant have devoured our people. They wrapped Rabbi Hananya ben Tradion in the Torah he loved and lived by and taught with awe, in defiance of the Romans, craving the teaching as fish crave water. Hananya was not the first Jew to be bound and burned by the Amalek enemy, nor would he be the last. That was certain. You may burn a Torah, but Torah will not be consumed. You may kill Jews, but the Jews will survive and serve witness to the Genesis patterns of creation and the Isaiah prophecies of hope. To walk humbly with your God, these words are written over the gate which leads out of the mysterious, miraculous light of the divine sanctuary. We have stood before God at the gates of the inner sanctuary seeking our atonement.
Now we begin the journey back to the world. The path of life leads us home.
I have taken an oath to remember it all, to remember not once to forget. Forget not one thing till the last generation, till the grief disappears, to the last, to its ending.
Till the punishing blows are ended for good, I swear this year I'll not live unchanged.
The authentic individual is neither an end nor a beginning, but a link between ages, both memory and expectation.
For the Jewish people, every moment is a new beginning. Within a continuum of history.
Be faithful, be true, love one another as you love yourselves. Endure ambiguity and make light shine through it. Stand fast in uncertainty.
Be capable of unlimited love and hope.
People of Israel lives after exile and dispersion, persecution, inquisition, deportation, pogrom, genocide. Our people still lives. And miraculously, after thousands of years of longing to return home, we rebuilt a homeland in the land of Israel. And so as we sing Yerushalayim Shel Zahav, we share photos of our pilgrimages there, of our recent trips, highlighting the redemptive promise of the Jewish state.
Salul Kayain Vrea Harani Nisav Ruach Arbaim Im Kol Pamoni Uftar Demat Ilan Vaeven Shvuya Bachaloma Ha'ir Asher Bada Yoshevet uveliba choma Yerushalayim shel zahav v'shel nechoshet v'shel or ala lechol shirayich ani kinor Yerushalayim shel zahav shall the horset be shallow? Halal a horse, she ani
היום לשיר לך ולך לקשוק תרים קטונתי מציר בנייך ומאחרון המשורים כי שמך צורב את השפתיים כי נשיקה צרף אם אשכחך ירושלים אשר כולה זהב ירושלים של זהב ושל נחושת ושל אור עלו לכל שירייך אני כינור ירושלים